I'm Justin Kanacki. I am the creator, writer, producer, director of Something to Be Desired, which is a web-based sitcom here in Pittsburgh that's now in its fifth year. When we started Something to Be Desired, it was born out of the idea that we had a short film script and we wanted to sort of see what happens to these characters after that, you know, 90-minute or 45-minute snapshot of their lives is over. We sort of got attached to them as we were creating this concept, and we said, well, we don't want to have to wrap everything up in one tiny little package. You know, we'd like to see how it grows and how these characters change over time. So the only way to do that was in some sort of sequential, serialized show, which really had never been done on the internet at the time we were thinking of it, which was 1999. So we sort of had to kick that idea around for a little bit. But we brought together a cast of about eight aspiring actors and turned this short film script into five episodes just to see if we could do it. And we put it on the internet and we got some good feedback and decided, well, let's take it from there and just as an experiment see where it goes. And 5 years later, we haven't gone broke yet, so we just keep doing it because nobody told us not to. When we first started the show, obviously, the show came out in 2003, so we didn't have YouTube, we didn't have iTunes, we didn't have any popular websites or search engine capability for video at that point because it was such a new and novel at that time concept. So most of our promotions had to do with just telling friends, friends of friends, coworkers, extended family members that we hadn't seen in years. And that's where most of our initial feedback came from. But then because a lot of the cast were in college, you know, word of mouth spreads through them. We had some folks from tech companies who were doing searches on how to create video at that time, and they started to come across our show because it was one of the only things on the internet at that time. So we were sort of like the guinea pig for a lot of people to see what would or wouldn't work. In addition to showing these characters evolving over time, the other thing artistically was we didn't want to spend a year or two trying to create a film, then put it out there into a festival or two or three, and then maybe get feedback 5, 6, 7 months later. We wanted to actually hear about it the next week. You know, and that's the beauty of the internet, is you can put something out there, within hours you've got feedback. In a lot of ways, where you're distributed these days doesn't seem to matter as much as it used to, because you're seeing a lot of the same content that's on the internet also showing up on mobile devices, also showing up on television through TiVo and Akimbo and other deals where they can lift web content that was web only and now transfer it to traditional television means. So the good news about that is where you initially start out being distributed doesn't matter. The tricky part is now we're all in competition for the same amount of attention. So the fact that I could produce a show here in Pittsburgh with a minimal budget and, you know, a cast of you know, aspiring actors puts me in the same competition for attention span with people who are producing Hollywood content, people who are writing the great American novel. So we're all fighting for that same 24-hour segment. The more places we can be distributed, the better. So yeah, we'd obviously love to have STBD on every, you know, mobile billboard and on the back of your JetBlue seat, but we're not quite there yet, though we're totally open to that, JetBlue, and if you're listening, call me. My number should be at the bottom of the screen. We were nominated earlier this year for the Yahoo Video Awards. We were one of the five nominees for Best Web Series. How they found us, I'm not entirely certain. I had nothing to do with it myself, I swear. But the fact that, you know, an organization that's dedicated to trying to push the video envelope and make it a mainstream thing decided that out of all the web series out there, we're one of the five best was a compliment to us. I try not to put a lot of stock in awards. At the same time, I hate to lose them. So it was nice to be nominated. It was great to come in third. And we're just really proud of the fact that we were nominated in the first place. There was a decision we made really early on was to not necessarily promote the city of Pittsburgh, but admit that we're from Pittsburgh. And that was for two reasons. One is you really don't see a whole lot of depictions of Pittsburgh in popular media. When you do see Pittsburgh in a film, it's usually pretending to be Chicago or New York or someplace else, because our film commission loves to sell Pittsburgh as this generic looking city that could be any major city. We, being Pittsburghers, happen to like Pittsburgh and wanted the world to know we were from there. And the other part of it to us was you can't do a realistic show about living in a specific city without admitting, you know, that that city sort of has its ups and downs, it has its problems. So we decided instead of saying, you know, the transportation system should stand to be improved, we started to talk about the actual Pat Transit system and things like that. And the funny thing about it is a lot of the viewers who sort of stumble across us on the internet are ex-Pittsburghers who were searching for information about Pittsburgh or searching for images and things that they, you know, they miss about the city. And they come to us and they say, it's great to be able to see where I came from now on a weekly basis because they can't see it on regular television. I was egotistical enough to think it could go forever. So yeah, I mean, the fact that it's gone for 5 seasons surprises a lot of people, but I don't know when to stop doing things, so it doesn't surprise me at all. I think it shocks the cast. They've been doing it for free for 5 years, but we'll fix that. Hi, I'm Justin Kanacki, creator of the hit web series Something to Be Desired, and I'm coming to PodCamp Pittsburgh 3 on October 18th and 19th, 2008. Are you Canadian?